This is Adi Sharma's solution, class 11th, chapter 32, statistics. Exercise is 32.3. So the question here are based on mean deviation, but the mean deviation of a grouped or continuous frequency distribution, we don't have individual data, we don't have any frequency with the XI or the data. But we have a frequency with the class interval. So class interval, so we have to find out mean deviation around mean also and median also. So we'll see questions around median and around mean. So you'll have classes here and you'll have frequencies. So in order to get the final mean deviation, you have to find either median or the mean. First question is, compute the mean deviation from the median of the following distribution. So we have to find first the median. So there, the two columns are given to you. This is in your question. So we have a class and a frequency. So this class, basically we need certain value. How do we find a central value or a value? You cannot have 0 or 10 because it is representing a class. So we'll add them and divide by 2. That is 0 plus 10 by 2. This is going to be 5. This is mid value you are going to take, and we'll regard it as XI. For example, 30, 40. 30 plus 40 by 2, 70 by 2. And that is going to be 35. And this 35 will be the central value. And this is what we are going to use. In case of mean, we'll not go to class again. But in case of median, we have to go to the class again. So let us see first what we do. Because we have to find out mean deviation from the median, for that what we have to do? We need cumulative frequency. We have, in order to find out median, we have to have cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency is the addition of the previous terms of frequency. That is, 5 will remain 5. 5 plus 10 is 15, 5 plus 10 plus 20 is 35, 5 plus 20, 10 plus 20 plus 5 is 40, 5 plus 10 plus 20 plus 5 plus 10 is 50. So every cumulative frequency is the addition of the previous frequencies. Now, one more thing important, the cumulative frequency, last frequency, has to be equal to the sum of the frequency. That is, if you add from 5 to 10, whole second column, that is capital N, which is basically sigma fi only, from I equal 1 to 5, 5 terms are there. So when it is coming 50, the cumulative frequency last term also should be 50, capital N, right? Now coming to the cumulative frequency, now we have to find out the median. How to find out the median? The way is, first you have to go to the sum of frequency, that is the cumulative frequency last value, capital N. But before that, the formula is there, L plus N by 2 minus capital F by small f into h. L plus n by 2 minus f by small f into h. Now we need to see what these values are. What is L? What is n by 2 capital F, f and h? You have n divided by 2 first. 50 divided by 2 is sigma f, or n divided by 2, it is 25. Now you have to, in cumulative frequency table, find out where 25 lies, in between which value, and you have to take the higher value. It is between 15 and 35. So you have to take the higher value. You have to take 35. 35 is just higher than 25. Now 35 cumulative frequency. Now you have to use this class interval and this frequency. You have to use the class interval also and the frequency and previous frequency also we have to use. So what all values are here? First thing is f. Small f is the frequency of this class interval. 20, 30. So 20 is small f. In this formula, we just wrote small f is frequency. Then in this interval, 20, 30, L is the lower limit. F is 20, we have already taken. F is 20. Now lower limit, upper limit, L is the lower limit. So what is the lower limit of this class? It's 20. So you have to take 20 here. L will be 20. N by 2, we have already found out it is 25. So you'll take n by 2 as 25. What is capital F? Capital F is the previous cumulative frequency. Please understand, It is the previous cumulative frequency, not the previous frequency, cumulative frequency. So you'll take 15 here. Capital F is 15, previous cumulative frequency. And what about H? H is the class interval. If you subtract any of the upper limit with the lower limit, you will find H, that is 10. So 20 minus 10 is 0, 10 minus 0 or any one is 10. Now we know all the values, put it in this formula, 25 is going to come. So now the median is 25. We have just reached half mark because still we have mean deviation to be found out. 25 is the median. Now we have median. When we will solve for mean also, from here everything will be same. So now we have to find D. D will be what? X minus 25. Basically we are finding DI because there are five data. I is for I 1 to 5. So XI minus 25. You have to subtract 25 from each of the mid values. That is 5 minus 25, 15 minus 25, 25 minus 25. And you have to take the modulus. That is positive sign you have to take. 5 minus 25 is minus 20. 15 minus 25 is minus 10. 25 minus 25 is 0. 35 minus 25 is 10. 45 minus 25 is 20. Take the modulus. Always take the positive sign. So this column will come. Now, one more step. The second column and this fifth column, you have to multiply corresponding terms. 5 into 20, 100. 100. 10 into 10, 100. 20 into 0, 0. 5 into 10, 50. 10 into 20, 200. Now, FIDI, you have to add all of these, FIDI. So this will come as 450. So sigma FIDI, 450. This is I equals 1 to N, sigma FI. This is also going from I equal 1 to N. This is your mean deviation. FIDI, sigma FIDI is what? This is 450. I goes from 1 to 5 because 5 terms are there, 450. What is sigma FI, which is capital N, which is 50? Divide it. What do you get? Find answer 45. You get 9. 9 is the mean deviation around a median. So I hope you got the idea. All the questions which are coming of median will just go through. Now question number second. All these questions are, three parts are there. All these are NCERT questions. So most of the questions are mean and median based, and you need to understand these well so that you solve the others well. And this is specifically for the grouped or continuous frequency distribution. Now we'll find out the mean deviation from mean. So first question is from NCERT. These classes and frequency are given to you. In the question, if you see your textbook, you'll see that classes and frequencies are given. So the 100-100 differences till 800 is there. Frequencies is also given. So we can directly not use these classes. We have to find out the midpoints. Take the lower limit and the upper limit. Higher limit also we say. So lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Take one example. Say 500 by 600 divided by 2. And that is going to be 1100 by 2. 1100 by 2 is what? It's 550. So you have to do it for every element. 0 plus 100 by 2 is 50. 100 plus 200 by 2 is 150, like this. So now you have a midpoint. You have a midpoint now. Okay. What you have to do is you have to find out the mean first. Mean. In order to find out mean, you have to multiply F, the second and third column. Fi Xi, sigma Fi Xi divided by sigma Fi. So take second column and third column, multiply them. 4 into 50 is 200. Last one is 3 into 750, 2250. So you have to do it for every element. Sigma Fi Xi is the addition of all this. So when you add this fourth column, all values, you're going to get sigma Fi Xi. That is going to be 17,900. Sigma Fi was already 50, sigma Fi. You just add second column, it's going to be 50. So what do you get? You get 358. This is the X bar. Now you have got the mean. Now same thing you have to do what we have done in the previous question. The next steps remains the same. So you have to multiply, you have to subtract 358 from each of the value of the third column, which is midpoint Xi. So Xi minus 358, you have to do it for every column and you have to take the positive sign. 50 minus 358 is 308 minus negative of 308. You have to take the positive sign. Let us take the last one. 751 as 358 is 392. And you have to take the positive sign. Positive sign. So 392 will come. You have to subtract each element of the third column with 358. When you get this, now you have this fifth column. Now you have to multiply this second column with the fifth column. Second column and the fifth column. Fi into xi minus x bar, you have to multiply. So multiply the second and fifth column. What do you get? 3 into 392, 1176, like this. Now you have to take this summation of all this. Sigma Fi into xi minus x bar. X bar you have already found out, 358. Add them. That is going to be sigma Fi xi minus x bar. This is sigma. I is 1, 2. There are 8 terms. Fi xi minus x bar. This is 7896 divided by sigma Fi, which is eventually capital N only. So you divide it by 50. This is going to be 157.92. I hope you got the idea. Mean, median, both of them. This is also same thing, NCRT question. So let me just give you a brief idea about this also. Same thing. So midpoint you have to find out. Just add lower and upper limit divided by 2 for all of them. Upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. This is midpoint xi. Fi xi. Now multiply this second column and third column, Fi xi. Then you add all these fourth column values. 13630 will come. Now divided by sigma Fi, which is capital N, 106. This is going to be your mean x bar, mean. Now when you got the mean, which is here, 128.58. Now what do? Subtract each value of the third column, which is xi, this 128.58. Just remove this from all the values. You get the value and you have to take the modulus. You have to take the positive sign. Subtract this 128.58 and take the positive sign. Now multiply the second column with the fifth column. You'll get Fi xi minus x bar. So when you multiply and then add this column, add the sixth column. So you have sigma Fi xi minus x bar. And this is, that is going to come as 1272.6. Sigma Fi is already known to us, 106, which is capital N. So 12.005 is going to come. This is going to be your answer. Third one is exactly same like this, right? Same Fi xi you have to find out, then you x bar, sigma Fi xi by sigma F, multiply by Fi into this x minus xi minus x bar. X bar will come as 27. Then you add them, 512 by 50 is going to be your 10.24. You have to subtract this 27 mean with every column of xi. Multiply Fi with xi minus x bar, then add this. As I said, 512 is going to come. Divide by 50, 10.24 is the answer. Question 3. Compute the mean deviation from the mean of the following distribution. So the same thing you have to do. We have just done mean question. Same thing you have to do. Question number 4. The age distribution of 100 life insurance policy holders is as follows. Calculate the mean deviation from the median age. So same thing you have to do here. Okay. So I now taking this age distribution of 100 insurance policy holders is as follows. Calculate the mean deviation from the median age. Okay. So first thing what you have to do is you have to add. Everything you have to do is the same way I told you in the earlier question. You just have to add lower upper limit and divide by 2. Then you have to find out the cumulative frequency because you have to find out the median. So you have to find out the median. For that you have to take the cumulative frequency. Now this cumulative frequency is the sum of the previous frequencies. The last cumulative frequency has to match your sum of the frequencies. That is 96. Now divide 96 by 2, that is the capital N or sigma Fi. What do you get? 48. 48 comes in between 33 and 59. Now you have to take this class. So in this, what you see, L plus N by 2 minus F by F into H. What all value are you going to take? I'll just give you a hint. This formula, what you're going to take. Lower limit is 35.75. Lower limit is 35.75. And by 2, you already found out 48. Now this previous capital F is previous one, 33. 33 is capital F. Small f is the frequency of this class, so 26 will be there. And what is the class interval? Subtract upper limit by lower limit, any of these values. You can take any of the value, it will come as 7. The value is 5 actually. So now you just put it here, it is median. Now this take all the xi value, subtract this median from each of the value of fourth column, 18.25 minus 38.63, take the modulus also. It will come as minus 20.38. Take the modulus, it will come as 20.38. You have to do for every term, and then what do you get? Di, multiply the second column with the fifth column, sigma, this FIDI. Now take the addition, sigma FIDI. This is 988.36 divided by the sigma F, which is 96, and 10.29 is going to come. Question 5. Find the mean deviation from the mean and from median of the following distribution. So mean deviation have to be found out, but here you have to find mean and median both. Please remember, mean and median both you have to do. So let us see this fifth question, because this is a question where both of the skills you have to understand. We have learned about mean, we have learned about median. So let us find out the median first, and then we'll find out the mean, and then we'll try to find out mean deviation in both the cases. The columns have increased. So first we have the median. So let us take the middle point first. And before that, because median is there, let us find the cumulative frequency. So cumulative frequency will come as last will be 50. And midpoints you have to take both. Midpoint is for both, mean median. So take the upper limit, lower limit, and divide by 2. 10 plus 0 by 2 is 5. 10 and 20 plus 10 by 2 is 15, like this. All these midpoint will come. Now cumulative frequency is known. We have a formula for median, L plus N by 2 minus capital F by F into H. Right? So this is N by 2, which is 50 by 2, 25. 25 comes between 13 and 28. So small l will be 20 for this interval. Then what is the small f, which is going to be 15 of the frequency? The previous frequency is 13. So capital F will be 13. H is what? 10 minus 0. So 10. You have to put it this in formula and you'll get a median. So what do you get? Median 28. Now you have a median. Now take the fourth column, and fourth column mean this. Because first we have to find out this DI and then FIDI. So first we will do what? Subtract each value of the fourth column. 28 remove every value. 28 remove difference of 28. 5 minus 28 is minus 23. Take the positive value. 23 will come. See, 15 minus 28 minus 13. You have to take positive value. So DI will come. Now this second column and the fifth column you have to multiply, FIDI. Now just multiply them and add them. Sigma FIDI will come. This will come as 478 divided by capital N is the value which we got. Okay. Now this 9.44 has come. Now for mean, what do you have to do? FI is already there. XI is already there. So FI into XI. Just multiply the second column with the fourth column. You don't have to subtract anything. Okay. FIXI. This is FIXI. This is FXXI. Now add this. 1350 will come. Now sigma FIXI by sigma FI, which is capital N, is going to be your mean. Mean. So you get 27. Now this is your mean. Now subtract this 27 from each value of the fourth column. 5 minus 27, 15 minus 27, and you have to take the positive values. It will come as, 5 minus 25 is minus 22. So you'll have to take the modulus. 5 minus 27 is 22. Right? So take the positive values, multiply the second column with this column, which I'm pointing out, and then you get Fi minus Xi minus 27. Add all of these, 472 will come, divide by 50. 9.44 is going to come. So in the same question, mean, median, we both found out. Next one is, calculate the mean deviation about median age for the age distribution of 100% given below. Now there is a catch. We are trying to find out grouped or continuous frequency distribution, but this is not a continuous distribution. How? Let me tell you. Well, what is the problem? The question is not this one, okay? Question is not this one. The frequency is okay, which is given in the question, but the question which is given, let me write it. I'm writing it here. This is what is given in your question, the age. 60 into 20, frequency is 5. 21 to 25, frequency is 6. 26 to 30, frequency is 12. 31 to 35, frequency is 14. 36 to 40, frequency is 26. 41 to 45, frequency is 12. 46 to 50, frequency is 16. And 51 to 55, frequency is 9. Now what is the problem here? The problem is 16 to 20, 21 to 25. What about 20 to 21? There is no data about 20.1. There is no data about 20.5. So there is a break. This is not a continuous frequency range or continuous data. What I'm trying to suggest is 16 to 20 is there. 21 to 25 is also given. What about 20 and 21? Between 20 and 21. So what do we do this? There's a way to do this. We subtract 0.5 from 16.5 and we add 0.5 to 20. We subtract 0.5 to the lower limit and we add 0.5 to the upper limit. You have to do it for every lower limit and upper limit. For example, 21 minus 0.5 is 20.5. 25 plus 0.5 is 25.5. When you have this, 15.5 to 20.5 and 20.5 to 25.5, you see 25.5 and 20.5, so we have a continuous range. There is no break. Okay, now rest thing you know. This is our age. You can do this now. Frequency is also known. Age is also known. And you have to find out about median. So you have to find out cumulative frequency. Before that, let's take the lower and upper and divide by 2, which is your midpoint xi. Cumulative frequency has to be equal to the sigma f. FIDI you have to find out. Before that, we have to find out the median. Cumulative frequency, see, capital N by 2, 100 by 2 is 50. Now try to find out where 50 lies in the cumulative frequency table, that is the fourth column. So 50 comes between what? 37 and 63. 37 and 63. So now you have to take 63 whole row, that is the class interval you have to take. Lower limit is 35.5L. What is capital F? Previous frequency, cumulative frequency 37. What is the frequency of this class? 26, which is your small f. What is the class interval? 5. 20.5 minus 15.5 is 5. Now put it in this formula, 38 degrees going to come. Now take DI, which is, you have to take the third column, subtract 38 from this column. So this is just a repetition, it's just being repeated, so just ignore it. Now you have to subtract from this third column 38 because it is the median. 18 minus 30 is minus 20, take the modulus, you'll get 20. You have to subtract 20 from each of this and now you have to multiply second column with the fifth column. You get these values, take the sigma, 735 divided by 100, it is going to be 7.35. This is going to be your answer, okay? So there are certain more questions being given. Some of the editions have. If you have that question, so it is in front of you. This is assume mean question. I will be taking this shortly. Assume mean and some mean deviation is also there. Okay, this is all about this exercise. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.